In our very first program, you wrote a statement that printed out a simple text string to the console. Oftentimes, you'll work on data. Now, if you were developing a game, this data could be the player name, their high score, the number of health that they have, and so forth. Data can also be the player itself, each enemy on the screen, and any non-player characters that are actually in your game. Now, when referring to data, we put data in variables. Now, if you've done any sort of math, then you should be familiar with variables. Well, think about it like this. Try to solve this simple problem. Z equals x plus y. X equals 1 and y equals 2. Well, what does z equal? Well, if you substitute the values for the variables and then add them together, z will equal 3. Now, to define a variable, we must first set the type. Variables come in all sorts of type. If you want to store text, you define a string type. I'm not sure how the name string was used instead of text, but you can think of it as a string of characters. As for numbers, well, we have a lot of options. For a plain old number, you can use an int, short for integer. For a decimal number, you could use a double. There's a lot more, and we'll explore them soon enough. Once you set the type, you give your variable a name. Variables can be named whatever you want, although it's important to follow a naming convention. Naming conventions make it easy to understand what the variable is and how it is being used at a glance. Typically, each team has its own convention, but in the absence of one, developers follow Microsoft's lead, which is what we'll be doing throughout the course. Now, when picking a variable name, try to be descriptive and to the point. Avoid names with single letters or something vague. Variable names can only be one word, so if you want to add multiple words, use camel case. That is, combine the multiple words together and capitalize the first letter of each word. Okay, enough chatting. Let's make some variables now.
Okay, we're going to get busy creating some variables in C Sharp. So here I have my project open. If you don't have yours open, take the time now to open it up, and you can open up program.cs, and we're going to add our code underneath this console write line, the hello world. So we'll scroll down here. So creating variables can be a bit of an art and a bit of a science. Essentially, you want to be clear with your intention. So let's say I want to create a variable to hold the meaning of life. Well, the first thing I need to do is to declare my type, which is an integer. In this case, it's int, int, and you'll notice that it turns blue. The blue color indicates that it's a keyword, and this keyword makes it easier for me to understand what's going on in my program. I can see at a glance what this item is. In this case, this is an int. And I'm going to give this a name. So I'm going to call this meaning of life. And you'll notice I do this as one word. Now you notice we have this green squiggle here. It's telling me that the variable is declared but never used. This is just a helpful warning. I don't need to worry about this now. But in this case, we're going to set this to 42 like so. And now I have my variable all set. Again, I'm not using it right now, which is why we have the green squiggle. Now, I may also want to create another variable to hold the meaning of life, and if I choose the same name, you'll see I get a red squiggle. Again, this indicates that we have an error. So you'll see here it says a variable is already defined in this scope. So this just means I have another variable called the meaning of life. And if I try to run this, I can go up to, let me see, it's under build here. We can do build solution. It's going to try to compile this program for us. And you can see the program started, and now I have an error down here. It says one error and two warnings. A local variable named meaning of life is already defined in the scope. And if I can click on this, if I click on this here, it takes me to exactly the line where that issue is occurring. So what we're going to do is we're going to delete that. Now I can also create another variable called meaning of life, and we'll assign this to 42. And when I do this, you'll notice we just get a green squiggle. We don't get an error message. And this is because these are two different variables. Casing matters. So this is a lowercase meaning of life, and this is uppercase meaning of life. So essentially, we've defined two different variable types. Now there are times when you do use uppercase, but for now, we're gonna start all our variables lowercase. You know what I'll do is I will simply comment these out. Now, so far we've been defining the type and then defining the name of the variable. But if you don't want to worry about the type, you can use the var keyword. So we'll create another variable, and this will be called the meaning of life. And this will be 42. And we get the green squiggle, but we get no errors. So this is a valid variable. And we can also start our variables with an underscore. So we can call this the meaning of life, like so. And again, this is another unique variable. There are times when you actually do use underscores with variables, and that's typically when you're working with properties. Now we can also do text as well. So in this case, I can do my name. My name is Brian, and this is a type string. So I could do var like that, and let's comment this out here. Or I could do something like this. And these two would be identical. If we wanted to get pi, we could use floating point, like so. And this is a type of double. And we also have true false values as well. So we can choose one that's is good, and we can set to true. And we can do another one called is bad, and we can set to false. And you can see here, these are also colored blue, indicating that true and false are keywords, and you'll be using them a lot when you're doing programming. Now we can put these variables to use, and we can do that by writing them out to the console. If you remember your statement, it's console.writeline. And we'll print out a little message. We'll say the meaning of life. And we'll do is dot 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 dot. Now, as you write C#, you're going to be using console.writeline a lot. And thankfully, C# has actually provided a shortcut to us. So what we can do is type CW, and you'll see we have this little box here that is all highlighted, and this is called a code snippet. Now, if we just keep it at CW and press tab twice, 1, 2, you'll see it writes that out for us. So this makes working with code so much easier, and there are lots and lots of different snippets that you'll be using throughout your C# programming career. Now, if you're curious to how to actually learn various snippets, what you can do is go up to the tools here, and then you can scroll down or mouse down to the Snippets Manager. So let's find this. Here's our code Snippets Manager, and you can open this, and you can see all these various snippets that are available to us. Well, what we want to do is select our language and choose C#. And here in Visual C# here, you can see of these various keywords that we can use. So if we want to use check out the if snippet, you'll see the shortcut is if. So if I come down here and type if, and then simply tab over, you can see it creates an if statement for me. Just something to keep in mind as you work with C#. Okay, now we're going to print out the meaning of life here. And when I print out the meaning of life, you can see here the green squiggle underneath this variable goes away, because this means I'm now using it. And we'll print out, we'll do CW again, is good. Now what I can do is do a simple build solution here, and I'm going to scroll up this output. And you'll see that we've succeeded the build, but if I go to my error list, you can see all these warnings. A warning simply means the program will compile. So C# is able to convert our program into machine code, but there are some issues that may cause problems down the road. In this case, you can see all the various warnings. They're telling me that I'm declaring variables that I'm not using. For the most part, when you're working on your code, you want to get rid of all the warnings that you possibly can. Warnings can be an indication of, say, a crash or some problems with your code. So you don't really want to leave them hanging about. So let's comment out these variables here. And you can see as we do that, our warnings are going away. And now that we have none, let's build this one more time. We'll build solution here. And you can see here one succeeded and we have no warnings at all. Okay, let's run this. So I'm going to go to, let me see, build, debug, and we're gonna go start without debugging. Okay, let's run this. Let's select debug, start without debugging. And you can see it says, hello world, the meaning of life is 42. Is it good? True.
We use variables everywhere in C#. They are the basis of our programs. much like subscribers are the basis of our YouTube channel. So please hit that subscribe button so we can keep on putting out this content. Cheers.